For question number 6, the correct option is option 4. And to show the steps of solution, as you remember the figure given in the question, you can follow what I am doing. In step number 1, we shall find out moment of inertia of central disk. Out of the 7 disks, the one that is central, whose center is O, we will find that disk moment of inertia about the point O. So this is the figure, the central disk. Center of the disk is the point O. That's also a center of mass, because the disk is uniform distribution of mass. And for the disk of mass m and radius r, moment of inertia about an axis passing normally through this point O. You know the meaning of that? The plane of the disk coincides with the plane of your screen. So the normal to the disk is a line that is normal to the screen pointing towards the viewer. About that axis, standard formula, moment of inertia of the disk about the point O is half m r square, where m is the mass of the disk, capital R is the radius of the disk. That is step number 1. In step number 2, we shall find out moment of inertia of each of the 6 surrounding disks about the point O. A figure is helpful. This is a central disk, and I am showing one of the 6 surrounding disks in bold line. So this point is O, and this is the center of mass of the surrounding disk coinciding with its geometric center. It is obvious each disk having radius of r, separation between these 2 points, center of mass of the surrounding disk and the point O, that is the center of this central disk, that distance, this d must be equal to twice r. And what is moment of inertia of this surrounding disk about the point O? And for that we require, in addition to this formula, this parallel axis theorem, which says that, let me write it first, moment of inertia I is equal to ICM plus m into d square. Here ICM is the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis through its center of mass, m is the mass of the disk, I is the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis parallel to the previous axis but passing through a point at distance d from center of mass. So if you look at this figure, you can write down that for each surrounding disk, moment of inertia about the point O will be, let me call that I dash for distinction, that is first ICM about this point, moment of inertia is half m r square as usual. But we want the moment of inertia about a normal axis to this point. So this distance is d, twice r. So it's coming out to be m into, here d is twice r, so that is 2r whole square. This coming out to be half m r square plus 4 m r square, that is 9 by 2 m r square. I believe it's clear. While the central disk, moment of inertia about the point O is half m r square, for each of the 6 disks surrounding it, moment of inertia about the point O is 9 by 2 m r square, thanks to this parallel axis theorem. In the next step, step number 3, moment of inertia of the 7 disk system about the point O. 7 disk means 1 central disk and 6 surrounding disks together, whole system, about the point O. And this figure is helpful, 7 disk system. Point O is the center of the central disk, which is also the center of mass for the whole 7 disk system. And that will be how much? You can write it. This is, I'm calling it I, moment of inertia about the point O. Moment of inertia is a tensor quantity, but for simple case of rotation about a fixed axis, we can treat moment of inertia as a scalar. So you can add this up, this and this, by simply scalar addition, that is arithmetic addition. So we have the contribution of central disk that I called ICM, and there are six surrounding disks, each having moment of inertia of I dash about the point O. So you have got ICM plus 6 I dash, that is giving me half MR square plus 6 into 9 by 2 MR square. How much is that? 2 cancelling out, it's giving me 27 MR square plus half MR square, that is 55 by 2 MR square. This is the moment of inertia of the 7 disk system about the point O, and the question was to find moment of inertia about some other point, that is P. Wait for a moment. In the next step, that is step number 4, moment of inertia of the 7 disk system about the point P. Now, which is this point? Let me remind you with a figure. The 7 disk system, the center of this system is the point O, that is center of mass for the whole system, but you're looking for moment of inertia about the point P located on the rim of a surrounding disk, about this point you want, right? And then once again, we require this parallel axis theorem, that is this one, I is equal to ICM plus MD square. We can write it, moment of inertia of this whole 7 disk system about the point P will be IO, that is moment of inertia about center of mass. Remember, O is center of mass for the 7 disk system also, plus MD square. For the whole system, the mass is 7m. And what about D, the distance from the point O, the point P, the distance, this much is R plus twice R, isn't it? So you can write it, this distance D dash is equal to R plus 2R, that is 3R, right? This is the D here, so it's coming out to be 7M into 3R whole square. I zero already found here, 55 by 2 MR square plus 7 into 9, 63 MR square is giving me 181 by 2 MR square, and that is the option 4 given. So our choice is option 4.